Oral Roberts and North Texas spring upset as NCAA tournament tips off. Oklahoma school becomes 9th number 15 seed to upset a number 2 number 13 North Texas, eliminate number 4 Purdue in overtime. 12 Oregon State scores 70-56 upset of number 5 Tennessee Inc. Loss drops Roy Williams to 29-1 in first round games. Oral Roberts welcomed the madness back to March. The 15th-seeded Golden Eagles pulled off the first major upset of the first NCAA tournament in 2 years, holding off second-seeded Big Ten power Ohio State 75-72 in overtime on Friday. The tiny evangelical school from Tulsa, enrollment 3,462, got poised impeccable performances from its two-star players, guard Max Abmas and forward Kevin Obanor, to become the 9th number 15 seed to win a first-round game, and the first since Middle Tennessee shocked Michigan State in 2016. Last year's tournament was called off because of the pandemic. Obanor scored 7 of Oral Roberts' 11 points in overtime, including 2 free throws with 13 seconds left, and finished with 30 points and 11 rebounds. Abbas scored 29 points. Ohio State could have tied it in the closing seconds of overtime, but Duane Washington Jr.'s open three-pointer from straightaway bounced off the side of the rim, and Oral Roberts celebrated its first tournament win since 1974. Oral Roberts joins Richmond, 1991, Santa Clara, 1993, Coppin State, 1997, Hampton, 2001, Norfolk State, 2012, Lehigh, 2012, Florida Gulf Coast, 2013, and Middle Tennessee, 2016, as the only number 15 seeds to win their opening tournament games. The Golden Eagles advanced to a Sunday meeting with 7th-seeded Florida, who earlier Friday reached the second round for an 8th straight NCAA tournament appearance, and with arguably its best player on the bench as a de facto assistant coach. Colin Castleton scored 19 points and grabbed 14 rebounds. Tree Man hit a step-back three-pointer with 23 seconds left in overtime, and the 7th-seeded Gators held off number 10-seed Virginia Tech 75-70 in a first-round game on Friday. Florida was cheered on by Keontae Johnson, who has supported and inspired his teammates from the bench since his return from a scary medical episode. Johnson collapsed on the court during a game in December and was hospitalized, forcing him to sit out the rest of the season. Day's second big upset came when 12-seeded Oregon State defeated number 5 Tennessee 70-56 in the Midwest region. Roman Silva scored 16 and Ethan Thompson 13 with 10 rebounds to lead the Beavers. Kean Johnson had 14 points and 6 rebounds for the Vols. Oregon State became the first Pac-10 12th school to win the conference tournament after being picked to finish last, and is now the 51st number 12 to take down a number 5 since the bracket expanded in 1985. Man's second big three-pointer gave the Gators a 74-70 lead, and proved enough after Cordell Pemsel's missed jumper with 10 seconds left. Third big surprise came in the evening, when 13th-seeded North Texas worked overtime to score a 78-69 win over number 4 Purdue. Javian Hamlet scored 24 points and Thomas Bell had 16, along with some game-changing defense in overtime, to lift the underdog Mean Green to the second teen powered upset of the Big Ten on opening day. What a great prize for Hamlet and Bell, a pair of seniors who led the Mean Green, 18-9, to a regular season conference USA title last year, but missed a chance at the tournament when the season was cancelled by COVID-19. In other early action, Number 3 Arkansas 185-68 over number 14 Colgate, while top-seeded Illinois rolled to a 78-49 victory over number 16 Drexel, who were making their NCAA tournament return after a 25-year absence. Elsewhere, Utah State's Nemias Queta made history in a lopsided loss to Texas Tech. Queta became the second player in the NCAA tournament since blocks became a recognized stat to finish with at least 10 points, 10 rebounds, 5 assists, and 5 blocks in a game. He had 11 points, 13 boards, 6 assists, and 7 blocks in a 65-53 loss to the Red Raiders. The other player to accomplish the feat was Baylor Zach Budo in 2010. Players from several teams took a knee during the playing of the national anthem before their first round games. Most of the players on 16th-seeded Drexel knelt for the anthem before the Dragons tipped off at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum, and several Colgate players did the same at Bankers Life Fieldhouse. A few players also took a knee during the anthem before the Florida-Virginia Tech starts at Hinkle Fieldhouse,